Meanwhile, more Hollywood fallout in the wake of the Harvey Weinstein sexual harassment and assault allegations. Amazon's programming chief, Roy Price, has been suspended after a producer for one of the company's shows says that Price repeatedly propositioned her at a company party back in 2015. Now, these allegations are coming just as actress Rose McGowan lashed out at the CEO of Amazon, Jeff Bezos, in a series of tweets. She claims the studio ignored her claims that Harvey Weinstein raped her. Meanwhile, TMZ reported yesterday that Harvey Weinstein's employment contract protected him from sexual harassment lawsuits. According to the report, to keep his job, Weinstein would have to just pay the company back any money that was paid out to victims and pay a fine, ranging from $250,000 for the first offense up to $1 million for multiple instances. Joining us right now is attorney and author Danielle McLaughlin. Danielle, good to see you. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
What kind of an idiotic clause is this?
I'll say it's curious. What the company was trying to do was inoculate itself from the money damages that might arise from a sexual harassment suit. I think one thing that's really important to understand here is that these companies, under California law and under New York law, are held strictly liable for the sexual assault or the sexual harassment of their executives. So it doesn't matter whether they bought that these were consensual affairs that he was covering up or whether they were concerned that it was predatory behavior. They're on the hook for this. And what they were trying to do is make sure if they were sued, Harvey would pay them back. And he would also be, there were punitive clauses. He would pay, as you say, $250, $500, escalating punitive clauses. It's unusual.
But just to have a clause in that basically tells you that we're expecting sexual harassment.
Yes, it says that they have a concern, that there's a risk that they are assigning a monetary value to, and that they are making sure that they will be inoculated from having to pay damages for his behavior.
But again, evidence that maybe not everybody knew, but people around Harvey Weinstein who had any interaction with him, male or female, knew what he was up to.
I mean, the joke about the casting couch in Hollywood is as old as Hollywood. Mm. So it isn't that surprising. What I think we're seeing is this groundswell of women who have been afraid to come forward because of the power and the concern about their own livelihoods, and some men. They're coming forward, and this may be a game changer.
All right, we'll be watching. Danielle, thank you. Danielle McLaughlin there.